It's an addiction. But it's a good addiction. There's something about being on two wheels. You feel like you can go anywhere or do anything.
My name's Carl Bjorklund and I'm with Super Rat.
Carl Bjorklund is a friend of mine. Mostly we just come over here to Carl's shop and just hang out.
Sometimes we just sit around and talk for an hour, just bouncing ideas off each other.
What do you want to do to the bike, Carl?
This is my own bike, so I was kind of wanting to build a little rack here.
You know, I thought it'd be cool to do a project with Carl because he's always making something and always down to make something.
If you're a fabricator, or a creator, or maker, there's always more to learn.
Well, the plan was just to make a rack, I guess.
Well, I think this will work good here.
We had a couple bullet points. We wanted to do some kind of thing that looked like a weave on top. We wanted to do wraps.
He knew he wanted to be roughly, I don't know, 12 inches long by roughly 9 inches wide.
You know, you can only make it so small before the corners all start running into each other. Plus, you don't want a really big bike with a really small rack.
In this case here, we use brass and silicon bronze. The brass, you know, looks really cool and it's a nice contrast to the bronze, but it's not readily weldable. But the silicon bronze welds pretty buttery.
It's so hard to make shapes out of metal. That's kind of why I'm drawn to metal. I like to punish myself.
That's slick.
We, in advance, had made a die for actually crimping that weave aspect into it. And just a little Sharpie center line on there, which we lined up with the center lines of each individual press. Carl just worked them through there and worked pretty slick.
Now we have all four of these pieces, which are gonna turn into corners. We got them drilled with a 3/16 hole so we can put these plugs in them. And the reason for that is when we weld this thing together, you can see how perfect the alignment ends up being.
So we got 5/8 here. 5/8. They pretty much need to be 4 5/8 inches and they're about a 1/2 inch long.
You can see how perfect all the alignment is.
You know, the 90 degree bronze pieces, that was so cool when they came together and that seam just disappeared.
See if this works.
Pressing all those, we kind of just use Sharpie lines, and so I was a little bit wondering, well, are these things gonna just drop in?
Very nice.
Because when you have a close tolerance of pieces that are all in a row, you can tell when one gets off, but they look great.
One of the things that we thought was a good idea was to basically bisect the support bars such that we could sort of tightly wrap it around the support hoop up top there. We ripped the length of it on the bandsaw and then sort of cleaned it up with the sander. Manually formed it over a piece of the material. One of the last steps is we run a 5/8 mill end down through it to perfectly shave the inside. So when we finally wrapped it over the bar, it just had a precise fit to it.
of us are professionals at heating and bending metal around objects. I was really happy that those all came out nice. I guess if you buff one thing, you kind of have to buff everything. If you know screws and hardware, you're gonna look at it and be like, oh, whoa, they buffed the screws too, that's cool.
I don't care who you are.
Nice rack.
I think it's pretty cool overall. This thing looks like a polished wedding ring.
We pretty much got exactly what we set out to do. And we wanted to do the woven stuff, we wanted to mix bronze and brass, and then we wanted to do wraps.
Turned out better than I expected.
And he's got really low standards too, so it's great.
Something we built that actually works. That's a win.